listeners, if you have a question for Jerry Portnoy, give us a call, 868-9171. We'll let you talk to Kevin, or we'll let you talk to Jerry. If we can pull the phone over there, it's a little bit awkward. It's not in that part of the studio, but we'll let you talk to Kevin, and you can call in your questions for Jerry Portnoy. We're going to listen to the first song, and this is Jerry on the vocals. The tune is called Charge It.
I'm wearing snakeskin shoes and sharkskin vines. I eat the choicest steaks, drink the finest wine. I live in style, it ain't so hard. All you got to do is use your credit card. Charge it, charge it if you please. Wear my cash, can't talk it off. But my credit card speaks Japanese. I get charged down at my local store. They tell me I could charge in Ecuador. I could charge in any circumstance. And when my money's short, I charge in cash and fast. Charge it. Charge it if you please. Well, my cash can't talk at all, but my credit card speaks Japanese. I ain't got a job, I'm unemployed. If I could raise some cash, I'd be overjoyed. I ain't got no money to say is mine, so I can only hope they raise my credit line. Charge it, charge it if you please. Well, my cash is deaf and dumb, but my credit card keeps Japanese. Charge my clothes, I could charge my meals, I could charge the gas, I use to fuel my wheels. I'm hoping pretty soon I'll find a way to charge these credit cards that I can't pay. Charge it, charge it, charge it hard. I'm gonna take my piece of bill and try to put it on my MasterCard.
Some people think I'm a square, 'cause I don't do what they do. I give it up whiskey and beer and wine too. I don't do cocaine, I don't smoke reefers or hash. But I get my kick when I feel cold cash. I want some money, I don't mean nickels and dimes. Just bring me lots and lots of money and let me count those dollar signs. I used to do all those things I mentioned to you. I drank and I smoked and chased women's too. I had a few laughs, I had a few thrills, but I found out pretty quick it wasn't paying my bills. I want some money, I'm talking dollars and cents. I want a bankroll of pictures of all those dead presidents.
That is, of course, Jerry Portnoy's tune, a tune called Money, done by a legendary blues band. And we've got Jerry Portnoy right here in the studio with us, right here in Boston. You're tuned to member-supported 89.7 FM WGBH Boston Blues After Hours. And we're kind of talking behind the scenes about music that crosses some of the boundaries of blues and some of the themes that kind of fit with pop music or fit with blues, or, you know, does what makes it blues and what makes it pop music? And I know Jerry's got some ideas that he might like to share on that.
Well, it's the thing is, if you categorize things in a real hard fashion, music doesn't sometimes work that way. And I'm certainly deeply rooted in blues, but I've been expanding. I grew up listening to a lot of music. I grew up at the end of the Second World War, and I heard the end of the big band era, and the swing bands, and the jump bands, and vocal groups, and a lot of varied material. And the new album reflects that, because I've got a tune that's done in three-part harmony. It's got a real 40s sound, kind of like the Mills Brothers. I grew up hearing that stuff. And I've got Poison Kisses, which is, you could probably be heard on any AOR station without anybody blinking an eye, but I think it's a great tune, and I've got Duke Robillard doing guest vocal on that.
It's hard to get something that, you know, if you get, I think Robert Cray was, I heard him on an interview on the TV the other day, and he was saying kind of the same thing, although his music is blues, he doesn't want to be pigeonholed into a blues category, although this show might be a blues show, but you know, anyone who is a blues musician wants to get that music out to as broad an audience as possible. And that, I think sometimes that's a really good thing that can happen to it.
Well, it's true that, I mean, blues doesn't get a chance to get out to the listening public as much. So I understand the reason that the playlist on a show like this would be limited. But a lot of people that play blues, I mean, around Chicago, you had to play a lot of stuff in the clubs. When in the mid-50s, Canadian Sunset was a big hit. Little Walter used to play it.
Oh, really?
Sure. Mm-hmm. And I put Misty on this album,
right,
which I've gotten received a few slings and arrows for, but other people have really loved it, and of course my version is unique.
It's a blues version.
Absolutely.
Right. We're going to play a blues tune, actually, but before we get to some more music, tell us about the work you've been doing with Eric Clapton. This kind of leads into that.
Well, I was over in London. He brought me over in February to play the shows at the Royal Albert Hall. He did 24 nights in sections of six. He did four different formats of six nights each. The third group was the six blues nights, and it was a lot of fun. I mean, every night was sold out. Mm-hmm.
Who was on that besides you and Clapton?
It's a beautiful hall.
Were there some other players?
Yeah, it was Clapton, Jimmy Vaughan, Albert Collins, Buddy Guy, and Robert Cray on guitars, Johnny Johnson on piano, myself on harmonica, Chuck Lavelle on organ, Joyce Pampinato from NRBQ on bass, and Jamie Oldacre on the drums.
Wow, that's a lot of guitar.
Yeah,
did you find any room for harmonica?
It was Guitar City. Well, I always... actually, Muddy had a pretty big band.
Yeah, he had three or four guitars a lot of the time, yeah.
I know how to try to weave in and out and stay out of people's way. Actually, if on some kinds of tunes like Hoodoo Man, which is probably going to be on the live recording of that, that'll be out, I believe, in the fall sometime. Normally, I would take all the fills because it's really a harp-oriented song. But if I would see Eric reaching for his guitar, I just back off. So I know how to do that. But actually, all that
that's what comes with old age, right?
when all the guitar players were up there, actually they were pretty cool because whoever was in the spotlight or leading that particular section, the other guys would just kind of lay back there and let the guy do his thing. So it worked out pretty well, and it was great fun.
Yeah, it sounds like a good time. We're going to play Blues in a Dream, and we're going to come back. Maybe we'll play a couple more off the album, and then we've got a Blues A to Z feature about the Aces. And I'm going to ask Jerry to stick around because he actually worked with a lot of the guys that were in the band, the Aces. You're tuned to Blues After Hours. This is WGBH Boston. Here's Blues in a Dream.
Thank you.
tune is called Blues in a Dream. Now, I understand we're having some trouble with our phones, so I'm going to give you another number to try. Apparently, they were working on the phones, and the phones are broken now. So I'll give you a regular switchboard number and the extension you can call, and you'll get through to Kevin if you do this. Our number is 492-2777, and the extension where you can reach Kevin to make blues requests or win some tickets, because we couldn't give away the tickets because the other phone is broken, is extension 2331. Again, that's 492-2777, extension 2331.
Last month, we asked you to support our programming here at 89.7 as we counted down to the end of our fiscal year. Many of you responded with your pledges, becoming new members, renewing, or making an additional gift. We'd like to thank you for your support, especially during these tough economic times. Your pledge enables us to continue to provide you and others with the best in jazz, classical, and folk music, and bring you quality news and public affairs. Many thanks again to all our members, and we hope to see you rain or shine in our Austin studios on September 7th and 8th for our Ice Cream Fun Fest. And if you haven't made your pledge, call now and join those who have. The number is 492-1111. And thank you from member-supported 89.7 FM, WGBH, Boston.
Yes, please do return your pledges if you pledged during our fundraiser. And if you didn't pledge, you still can. And that number again, just for tonight, to call to GBH is 492-2777, extension 2331. We are going to give away a couple of pairs of tickets to the record release party, Jerry Portnoy and the Streamliners, Thursday night at Night Stage. And, of course, the band is called Poison Kisses. We're going to listen to the title track in a moment or two. Jerry, tell them the question we aren't going to ask.
What was my first professional name? Actually, I used it for, I think, the first 6 months I was with Money.
And your mother's not going to call for the tickets, so.
I don't think so.
What's the answer? What was Jerry Portnoy's first professional stage name?
Well, I used to go under the handle J.P. Gordon.
J.P. Gordon? How'd you pick that?
Well, Gordon's my middle name. They used to call me J.P. around Chicago years ago.
Uh-huh. Well, while we're listening to Poison Kisses, why don't we come up with a real question? And then we'll do our feature on the Aces, and Jerry Portnoy is going to help out with that. Here's Poison Kisses.
That lips as sweet as wine, and the only problem is that I want to be her mine. But I know the poison kisses, poison kisses, has a spell on me I can't control. We'll be right back.
got me in the car, and I feel the fear this is just waiting for the hour when I can taste the poison kisses.
Poison kisses cast a spell on me I can't control. Poison kisses, the poison kisses, poison kisses, poison kisses, poison kisses, poison kisses, poison kisses, poison kisses.
We had a guest vocalist on that tune. That's Duke Robillard.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, that's great. You've worked a lot with him.
Yes, I have. He's one of my favorite musicians in the world.
You've worked with Freddie Bilo, too, of the Aces. Actually, Jerry, why don't you tell everybody the history of how the Aces got to be the Aces? Where were they before? It's kind of complicated, but they started out with...
Well, they started out with Junior Wells. They were Junior Wells' band in the early 50s, and then after Little Walter went out on his own, after he left Muddy's band in 52, after the success of Juke, Walter took over Junior Wells' band, and it became Little Walter and his Jukes, and Junior Wells joined Muddy's band.
So first they were the Jukes. Well, first they were...
I don't know what Junior...
They may not have had a band, just Junior Wells Blues Band maybe or something.
Maybe they...
Then they were the Jukes, and then they became the Aces. They worked with a lot of different people, Robert Lockwood, so on.
I worked with them quite a bit around Chicago, around the Midwest when I was with Johnny Young. Because
that was later, though. That was, what,
well, that was the
60s,
early,
yeah.
Yeah, late yeah. 60s, early 70s.
Well, what was Freddie Beeland like? He just died a couple years ago.
Huh? Yeah.
Not even. I think it was even in the last year he just died.
No, I think it was before that. He's been gone a couple of years at least. He was a great guy, and he wrote the book for blues drumming.
Yeah, you've played with some incredible drummers.
And Willie Smith.
Yeah, Willie is my favorite.
Oh, yeah, he's great. I just played a show with Willie a couple of nights ago up in Portland, Maine.
Uh-huh. Yeah, we were both out at that Assabet River Blues Festival. Yeah. Willie was on there. And he's singing now, too, which is...
Oh, he's singing. Yeah, he's hollering. And he sounds good, too.
Yeah. It's funny, you know, when people kind of come in front in a band. What were the Aces like on stage? Do you recall it all?
Well, Bilo was a lot of fun to work with. He was a real nice cat and a great drummer. And I'll never forget. I think the first time I sat in with him... they were playing behind Johnny Young. Big Walter was playing harp, and Walter brought me up to play, and Bilo asked me to play off the wall, so I did, and he came up to me afterwards and said, "Oh man, it's an honor to play with you." And I said, "Get out of here." I said, "Don't give me that stuff." I said, "That's my line, you know."
Yeah.
"An honor for me to play with you," because he's playing the drum break on the original, and he made the record, and all that sort of stuff. But he was a real nice guy. He was a lot of fun. He had a nice disposition. And he used to go around to all the blues clubs in Chicago with his camera. He used to kind of moonlight taking pictures. Like, you'd go to these, in the black clubs, there was always a photographer taking pictures of couples, whatever, sitting there having
their drinks. Polaroids that they would sell, yeah.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. So he did that a lot.
Great. Yeah, and you worked with Lewis Myers, too.
I worked with Lewis, with Johnny Young, and then of course he was in the legendary blues band. Actually, Duke went out and did our first tour, and then we had Lewis for about a year.
Right. And what was he like to work with? Quiet guy, he seemed to me.
He could be a little bit difficult at times.
We won't talk about that. And did you know Dave also?
Yeah, I knew Dave. Yeah. I knew Dave. The Myers brothers. The Myers family is an interesting family.
Actually, we've got a question.
Jack Myers was their he wasn't a brother. He was a cousin. He was a great bass player.
Yes, I know. Yeah, he's on a lot of different things, too. We have a question we're going to ask our listeners, and if you can answer this question correctly, we're going to give you a pair of tickets to go see Jerry's band in the record release party at Night Stage on Thursday night. That's Night Stage in Central Square in Cambridge. Here's the question. We know of the two Myers brothers, Dave and Lewis Myers. There's a third Myers brother. We'll give you a hint. He played harmonica. We're going to ask you for his first name. You might not know this. It's a little obscure, but maybe if you guess, you might get it. Our phone number tonight only, is 492-2777, extension 2331. Okay? The third Myers brothers, what we're looking for. We're going to send you to see Jerry's band, the Streamliners, and the record release party for Jerry Portnoy and the Streamliners at Night Stage on Thursday. We had a question that came in while they're thinking about that. We had a question that came in. Someone called and asked what the best way to learn blues harmonica is, whether you should learn by listening to records or just trying things out, or if you should take lessons. Now, of course, Jerry's got a kind of hidden agenda here because he gives harp lessons. So if that person wants to call back and, you know, work something out with Jerry, maybe they should call back. But
Well, you just have to immerse yourself in it, and of course, there's so much great stuff out on records. Since the advent of recorded music, people have been learning off of records, and Muddy never heard Robert Johnson. Muddy learned that stuff off of records, you know, off the old Victrola. So there's nothing wrong with that. There's all the greatest music is down on wax, and you have to listen to it all the time, and do the best you can with that, and go out and see live shows, listen to live players, and
you know, it seems to me that a lot of that stuff is real intuitive. It's almost like a blues player's got to be born to a certain extent. I mean, certainly getting good at stuff requires a lot of practice, but it seems to me there's something very intuitive about how things sort of get put together that you almost have to be born.
Well, there are different levels of talent. I mean, you could have two guys that are equally diligent and study the same stuff, but one is going to go a lot further because he's just got a greater natural gift in the way in his ear, and it's music is a gift, and some people have more of it than others.
Should we listen to some aces?
Sure.
All right. Don't forget, we are looking for a couple of people to get some tickets with the name of the third Myers brothers, 492-2777, extension 2331. Here are the aces. Jerry, I want to thank you so much for coming in. It was a great pleasure. You know so much about the Chicago blues scene.
I lived it, baby.
And we're going to play something else from your record. This one's by request.